So yeah, Sebrilius had to get some paint. These New England roads during the winter time, they are so salty, they end up just corroding whatever's underneath here. And regardless of quality of factory paint jobs and such, it's just never gonna last in the New England weather. So after 2 years and 60,000 miles of driving the Jeep, it needed its frame painted pretty extensively. So here we go. If you ask me, that looks pretty sharp. It's a hell of a lot better than New England rust, for sure. With a trip to Moab coming soon, it was time for Sebrilius to get some new shocks. So today I am unboxing my King Shocks. Now I picked King Shocks basically because they had an adjustability. There was few brands that had adjustability to their shocks, and I wanted to be able to adjust mine to compensate for the off-road sway bars, the Curry Off-Road Rock Jock sway bars. And I wanted something quality. I didn't want to go cheap this time. Why did I pick Kings? Well, I picked Kings because of the quality of the parts, and more so, I had been watching a lot of videos of them doing cutaways of the shocks and showing what was on the inside of the shocks. And me being a machinist, I know quality parts when I see them. So when they were taking these King shocks and they were cutting them in half, all I could see was beautifully machined parts. Every bit of these parts are anodized and well machined. So, I mean, quality in itself means a lot. And, you know, they might not work good at all. They might work great. I don't know. But I can tell you right now, they're very high quality, and I'm super excited to put these on the Gladiator. So stay tuned for that. Comes with directions. Always read the directions. I mean, get a load of these things. I mean, crazy good quality. See right out of the gate. I mean, look at the width of this shaft. I mean, it's probably the thickest shaft I think I've ever seen. You got a really thick shaft there, King. So as you can see, we got the rears. They have a permanently attached piggyback reservoir. There's the adjuster. I've played with these adjusters. There is 27 clicks. Now, that's a lot of adjustment. That's probably more adjustment than I'm ever gonna wanna play with. But if I do get real picky about the ride or the dampening, I can go 27 clicks either direction. So that ought to take care of my picky needs. So the fronts are gonna be a little bit more work than the backs, because the fronts, they need to be mounted in a way where these are up and out of the way. And due to the fact that I have 40 inch tires, I do have a little bit of a clearance issue in most cases, because they're bigger tires, they fill that wheel well. So gonna have to be a little bit more choosy about how I mount the fronts. The backs are obviously pretty straightforward, they just go in and you rock them like that. But the front, I'm gonna have to do a little homework on where to put that reservoir, where it ain't gonna rub on my tire. or where my tire's not gonna rub on it. Favorite tool. After a while, the sleeves just get sour in them and they just start to get sloppy and loose, but on the other hand, they were shrunken up to the point where the sleeves were actually longer than the bushings. What that made it do is made the shocks smack around on these sleeves. So my fix was to shave them down, and then the extra thickness, I made up for it with a nice thick washer in there, and that's how I kept the shocks nice and tight over time. But after 30,000-40,000 miles and a trip to Moab, it'll do it. Well, there you have it. There's one installed. Got three more to go. So I went and read the directions, and here's how it goes. I have to remove this jobby here, these two lines, and then I have to feed something through these existing holes right here next to the spring. But I need this bracket, and I need to mount this reservoir clamp to the back of the bracket. It slides in here, and then you bolt everything back up, and that reservoir will come right down through here. Now, the problem with it coming down through here, two things. I got this bracket right here that's holding this inner liner away from the tire. Second of all, I don't know if you can see this scrub mark right here in the fender liner, but that's where my tire hits. So that reservoir is literally going to be coming right through here, just missing my tire. So I'm definitely going to have to keep an eye on that and make sure I'm not scrubbing my brand new parts with my big knobby tires. Once that's installed or ish, this little thing, which is interesting, you drop it down in behind those two holes right there. And if you look, you just screw your screw right in there. Interesting. So I got this bracket put together and I've already run into a small problem. I put the bracket in there and it just does not want to go far enough over to meet up with this bolt right here. And I think it has to do with the fact that it's hitting the side of that shock mount right there. So I think I need to shave off a little bit so that I can get far enough over, which is pretty minor. You know me, I've done plenty of grinding on this puppy. What's another eighth of an inch? Got it. That's how it works. A little tab goes down in and you screw it in. It's not a lot of room for a hand. It looks like they had that figured out. In the way. So if you look at it, that bracket's in the way of the hose. The hose is gonna run right up through here and boom, it's right there. That's it. King 2.5 piggyback reservoir adjustable shock. I can't wait to test these things out. I'm gonna put these tires on and I got some new goodies that just came in the mail today. Out in Moab there is no shade, so I got some awnings and some privacy shower stuff, and we're gonna be playing with that next time. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel, and as always, thanks for watching. See you later.